Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 13th of January. After Serum Institute, Bharat Biotech dispatches Covaxin across India. Senior Afghan politician Khalili meets Pakistani leadership to discuss peace process. And Sri Lanka economically stable amid pandemic, says Finance Ministry. And now for all the details. India's Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech on Wednesday dispatched its first batch of indigenously made COVID-19 vaccine called Covaxin to several cities across the country. This comes a day after Serum Institute of India shipped batches of its Covishield, a variant of Oxford AstraZeneca's vaccine. Both the vaccines are expected to be used in the government's mass vaccination program against COVID-19 that is scheduled to start from January 16.
The first batch of Covaxin, the Made in India COVID-19 vaccine by Bharat Biotech, was shipped to several Indian cities from southern Hyderabad on Wednesday morning. According to officials, the vaccine boxes were shifted to the temperature-controlled facility at cargo terminals before being shipped out. This comes a day after the Serum Institute of India dispatched the first batch of its vaccine doses from Pune, from where it reached several storage facilities across the country.
पहला कंसाइनमेंट आया 94,000 का टोटल मिलाकर मध्य प्रदेश में 5,650 डोजेज आएंगे पहला भोपाल में दूसरा इंदौर में तीसरा जबलपुर और चौथा कल ग्वालियर में आएगा और भोपाल के कंसाइनमेंट का जो 8 यहां के जिले हैं उसमें डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन शुरू हो गया है
हम लोग के लिए बहुत ऐतिहासिक दिन है क्योंकि यहां पे कितने लोगों की डेथ हुई हम चाहते हैं कि ये वैक्सीन सभी लोगों को लगना चाहिए हेल्थ वर्कर के अलावा सभी को लगना चाहिए
India will start its vaccination drive on January 16, which the government says will be the largest vaccination drive in the world. India has approved two vaccines, including Serum Institute's Covishield, along with Bharat Biotech's Covaxin for emergency use. A couple of other vaccine candidates from India are under different phases of trials, including one from pharmaceutical giant Zydus Cadila.
Protesting Indian farmers burnt copies of the newly passed farm laws that liberalise agriculture sector as they continued their agitation against the reforms and marked the harvest festival of Lohri on Wednesday.
Protesting Indian farmers burnt copies of the government's new agricultural laws as they pressed on with their protest against the reforms and marked the midwinter harvest festival of Lohri on Wednesday. Thousands of farmers have camped on the outskirts of Indian capital New Delhi for almost 2 months. While farmer leaders have welcomed the Supreme Court's order to stay the implementation of three farm laws on Tuesday, they are not happy with the formation of a four-member committee to resolve the impasse. They said they would not call off their protest until the laws are repealed.
वार्ता से भी कुछ नहीं निकलेगा सरकार को बहाना बन गया है कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने स्टे कर दिया है कमेटी बना दिया वहां बात रख दो कुछ भी उसमें निकलने वाला नहींगा उसके बाद हम 26 तारीख वाला जेड़ा वो प्रोटेस्ट करेंगे आंदोलन हमारा लंबा चलेगा तगड़ा चलेगा आखिरी दम तक चलेगा जितनी देर है तीनों कानून रद्द नहीं हो जाते
क्योंकि सानू उत्ते कोई भी भरोसा नहीं कोई भी सानू उत्तो आस नहीं क्योंकि जो कमेटी बनेगी वो खेती कानूनों के हक में फैसला करेगी और चारों जो लोग उस कमेटी में शामिल किए गए हैं मेंबर बनाए गए हैं वो सरकार के बंदे हैं सरकार के आदमी हैं और उसके करेंगे असी उस कमेटी के सामने नहीं जाएंगे
Farmers have consistently called for the total repeal of the laws, which they believe are designed to benefit the large private buyers. While Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government has said there is no question of a repeal and the legislation was required to reform the agricultural sector. A 9th round of talks between the government and farmer unions is scheduled to take place on Friday.
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Tuesday said the crime syndicate responsible for the 1993 Mumbai bomb blast is given not just state protection but is enjoying five-star hospitality. He made the remarks during his address to the UN Security Council in a thinly veiled reference to the tea company head Dawood Ibrahim, believed to be hiding in Pakistan.
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Tuesday asserted that the international community must not allow terrorism to be justified and terrorists glorified, as he told the UN Security Council that the crime syndicate responsible for the 1993 Mumbai bomb blast is given not just state protection but enjoying five-star hospitality, a thinly veiled reference to the D Company head Dawood Ibrahim, believed to be hiding in Pakistan. This was the first time the Indian Foreign Minister addressed the Security Council after India began its two-year tenure on the 15-nation body this month. Jaishankar also proposed an 8-point action plan for the UN system to credibly address the menace of terrorism. He asserted that linkages between terrorism and transnational organized crime must be fully recognized and addressed vigorously.
We must not countenance double standards in this battle. Terrorists are terrorists. There is no good or bad distinction. Those who propagate this only have an agenda, and those who cover up for them are just as culpable.
India accuses Dawood Ibrahim of masterminding a dozen bombings and grenade attacks in Mumbai in March 1993, which killed at least 257 people. In August 2020, Pakistan had for the first time acknowledged Ibrahim's presence on its soil while imposing sanctions on 88 banned terror groups and their leaders under pressure from the Financial Action Task Force.
In news from Pakistan, senior Afghan politician Karim Khalili on Tuesday met Pakistani leadership, including Prime Minister Imran Khan, to discuss bilateral relations and the Afghan peace process. The prominent Afghan Shia leader's three-day visit came in the wake of brutal killings of 11 Shia coal miners in a targeted attack in Pakistan earlier this month.
Former Chief of Afghan High Peace Council Karim Khalili on Tuesday held a meeting with Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan in Islamabad, during which Khan said a peaceful and stable Afghanistan will open up new vistas of cooperation in trade and regional connectivity. Khalili and Khan during the meeting exchanged views on the Afghan peace process and bilateral relations between Pakistan and Afghanistan, informed Khan's office in a statement. The prominent Afghan Shia Muslim leader also held talks with Pakistan's Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi as the country continues to reel from the brutal killing of 11 Shia coal miners in a targeted attack earlier this month. This comes as peace talks between the Afghan government and the Taliban aimed at ending 20-year war in Pakistan's northwestern neighbor are being held in Doha. Pakistan claims it has facilitated the Afghan peace process, helping to bring the Afghan Taliban to the table, first with the United States, resulting in a historic agreement between those two warring parties in February last year.
Moving on, a protest was held recently by employees of Electricity Department in Pakistan-administered Kashmir to demand technical allowance, which they said is being deliberately denied to them. They blamed Pakistan of discrimination for systematically denying benefits, rights and resources to the people in the illegally occupied region.
The employees of Electricity Department in Pakistan-administered Kashmir recently held a sit-in protest to demand technical allowance, which they say is being deliberately denied to them. They blamed Pakistan, which claims a region of its own, has given similar allowances to technical workers in its provinces, but has turned a blind eye to the demands of those working in its illegally occupied territory. A revenue of 80 million rupees to be distributed as technical allowance has been a long-standing demand of Electricity Department employees. They said they will soon sit on a hunger strike to press for the demand, which has been ignored for years by the government in Pakistan-administered Kashmir that works at behest of Islamabad.
कई सालों से हड़तालें कर रहे हैं और कह रहे हैं कि हमें ये बुनियादी चीज़ दे दें। हमारे लोग परेशान हाल हैं, उनके छोटे छोटे बच्चे हैं, वो कोई लोग एक ही ग्रेड में रिटायर होकर यहाँ से महकमे से जा रहे हैं, तो हमारा कोई परेशान हाल नहीं है। हमारे लिए कानून तो होना चाहिए था, स्टेट के अंदर जो अलाउंस होना चाहिए था वो निजामतों को भी अंदर आते, लेकिन हमें वो अलाउंस नहीं मिला।
Locals have long blamed Pakistan has systematically denied benefits, rights and resources to the people of Pakistan-administered Kashmir for more than 7 decades of its illegal occupation.
Moving on to news from Sri Lanka. At a time when Sri Lanka is witnessing the second wave of the coronavirus, its finance ministry has said the government is successfully tackling the pandemic and building economic stability in the country. The total number of COVID-19 patients in the island nation has surpassed 48,000 with at least 244 deaths.
As Sri Lanka continues to record new COVID-19 cases daily, Ministry of Finance has said under the guidance of the President Gotabaya Rajapaksa and Prime Minister Mahinda Rajapaksa, the government is successfully tackling the global COVID-19 pandemic and building economic stability in the country. According to a statement released by the Finance Ministry, the national accounts estimates for the third quarter of 2020, released in the midst of reopening the country after the second wave of the COVID-19 pandemic, have also revealed the figures numerically supporting the economic stability of the country. This comes as Sri Lanka's economy, just like other countries, witnessed a downfall during the pandemic in 2020. The total number of COVID-19 patients in Sri Lanka has surpassed 48,000 after over 500 patients tested positive for the virus earlier this week, including 3 lawmakers. So far, 244 deaths have been reported in the island nation due to the virus.
A sports carnival is underway in Pehelgam town of India's Jammu and Kashmir to promote winter sports in the Union Territory. Over 30 martial artists are taking part in the 4-day event.
A 4-day sports carnival is being held in Pehelgam town of India's Jammu and Kashmir. The event is organized by a martial arts sports club in collaboration with the Directorate of Tourism Kashmir. Over 30 martial artists, including girls and boys, are participating in the carnival and are displaying their taekwondo skills in the snow-clad ring in Pehelgam.
हमारा यहाँ पहलगाम में इसका यही मकसद है यहाँ पे ये मुनक्कद कराने का कि इसमें पहलगाम में ये विंटर स्पोर्ट्स एक्टिविटी बढ़ जाए जो हम डिपार्टमेंट की तरफ से बहुत कोशिश कर रहे हैं पहलगाम में विंटर में ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा एक्टिविटीज़ बढ़ जाए।
फर्स्ट टाइम हो रहा है J&K में कि पहलगाम में टाइकोंडो का कैंप हो रहा है यहाँ पे और भारत में बच्चों ने ऐसे इतना यहाँ पे सपोर्ट किया है, डिमॉन्स्ट्रेशन दिया है।
Taekwondo is a form of martial arts that is gaining popularity in Kashmir Valley. Usually such sports activities are stopped during winter season in the Kashmir Valley where sub-zero temperatures cause water bodies to freeze. The sports carnival which started earlier this week is the first of its kind and ever.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. After Serum Institute, Bharat Biotech dispatches Covaxin across India. Senior Afghan politician Khalili meets Pakistani leadership to discuss peace process. And Sri Lanka economically stable amid pandemic, says Finance Ministry. Now viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.